Last time we did Taylor series expansion. So if there is a point z naught and f is analytic at z naught, function f is analytic, then there is a neighborhood of z naught throughout which f is analytic, throughout which f is analytic. And in this neighborhood, say suppose this is of radius r, so for z belonging to r neighborhood of z naught, we can express fz in the powers of z minus z naught. So fz can be written as sigma a n z minus z naught to the power n, n from 0 to infinity. Where this a n is nth derivative at z naught divided by factorial n. So this is called Taylor series of f around z naught. That is, f is expanded in the powers of z minus z naught, and the coefficients are nothing but the derivatives of f at point z naught divided by factorial n. So the Taylor series expansion of a function is valid around a point if f is analytic at that point, and this z can be chosen in the region where the function is analytic. So that is what Taylor series expansion means. Now next step is we will consider the situation where f may not be analytic. Okay, so now let us go to a situation where f may not be analytic at z naught. Okay, so let us consider. So let us go to Laurent series expansion. Laurent series expansion. So now the situation here is that f may not be analytic. Okay, so I will write down the theorem that there is some annular region in which f is analytic. So the Laurent series expansion, when we think about it, is in the region which is annular region around z naught. So z naught is this point. Okay, now f is not analytic at z naught. Typically in that situation Laurent series expansion is applicable. If f is analytic at z naught, then you can get Taylor series. So but then suppose f is not analytic at z naught, something like 1 over say 1 minus z, okay, at z equal to 1, it is not analytic. So if the region is mod z less than 1, so 1 is not in that, then you have Taylor series, that is 1 plus z square and so on. But if the region contains point 1, then there will be problem. Okay, so suppose f is not analytic at z naught, then you consider some annular region, and suppose f is analytic in this annular region, so here it may not be analytic, but then in this region it is analytic. Then for z belonging to this region, we can expand f, but that expansion, see here n is natural number, n from 0 to infinity. In the Laurent series, negative powers of z minus z naught will also come. That is, the powers of z minus z naught are negative, or could be negative. So Laurent series expansion of function which is not analytic at z naught in the powers of z minus z naught is possible, provided there is some annular region in which f is analytic, and for points in that region we can expand fz. Okay, so let me write the precise statement. Suppose that f is analytic throughout an annular domain. So suppose f is analytic in an annular domain R1 less than mod Z minus Z0 less than R2. So less than R2, and C be positively oriented simple closed curve at Z0, C be positively oriented simple closed curve which lies in this annular domain, lying in the annular region. Then at each point in this domain, that means that annular region domain, for each point z in the annular domain, fz can be written as, so this is Laurent series expansion, fz can be written as sigma an z minus z naught to the power n n from 0 to infinity plus sigma bn upon z minus z naught to the power n n from 0 to infinity. So see, these are powers of z minus z naught in the denominator. Now Taylor series only has series expansion like this, where you have z minus z naught square, like that. Here you have 1 upon z minus z naught, 1 upon z minus z naught, like that. This is from 1, because n equal to 0 term is a naught. Where an equal to, where these coefficients are, where an equal to one upon 2 pi I integral over c fs upon, or you may write fz with the same notation as fz upon z minus z naught to the power n plus 1 dz, and bn equal to 1 upon 2 pi I integral over c fz upon z minus z naught to the power minus n plus 1 dz. Where n is natural number. Once you write in the denominator, it is natural number. So this coefficients an and bn are found like this. So this total statement we want to prove. Remember.